instead of spending his per diems on solid-ass ballpark hammers. A most surreal homage to Yogi and a Warhol mess of a Dodger dog made Vincent think he'd very soon be living high in style off the total hog. Success of House of Usher began a series of Roger Corman flicks. Vincent combined his highbrow efforts with drive-in fodder produced for Hicks. Filmgoers couldn't really get a grip on those Dr. Goldfoot abominations. They had no idea that Vincent spent his dough on so many wooden shaft sins. We'll be right back.
So what happened after that?
Long box with fellow horror man Christopher Lee. What had become of all the casket wood of a major AIP mystery? When they heard a grinder in the wood shop, that's where they began to smell a rat. And found old Vincent bending over a lathe trying to fasten a total baseball bat. After that ill-fated trick was finished, Vincent put his pay into an Adirondack stack, made a pilgrimage to the lumberyard to select the finest solid ash block made with the CEO of Rawlings Inc., who first had told him no way, no dice, to grind out the ultimate baseball bat, the personal motto of Vincent Price. Exactly how, my friends, Rawlings made the finest baseball park slammer. When the classical actor oversaw the ultimate erection of Vincent's hammer. For years on the eves of special occasions, Vincent would curl right up on a special mat and cradle this totally one and only personal price mark baseball bat. We'll be right back.
flexible whip action, man.